Bryansk Governor Alexander Bogomaz claimed that a Ukrainian sabotage group attempted to breach the border. He announced this on Telegram. In the Klimovo district of the Bryansk region, a Ukrainian sabotage group's attempt to infiltrate the Russian Federation was thwarted, his post read. According to Bogomaz, Russian forces allegedly engaged the group with fire, preventing the breach. The Shot Telegram channel reported the group consisted of approximately 200 Ukrainian soldiers. The Ukrainian group's movement near the border was detected. They were then hit by fire and forced to retreat with losses, the channel's report stated. Bryansk Oblast lies west of embattled Kursk Oblast, north of Ukraine's Chernihiv and Sumy Oblasts, and east of the Belarusian border. The Russian governor claims that the situation in Bryansk Oblast was stabilized and is under control. As Kyiv's incursion in Kursk Oblast entered its third week, Moscow announced that it would establish troop groups in Belgorod, Kursk, and Bryansk Oblasts to defend settlements along the Ukrainian border. Ukraine's commander-in-chief, Oleksandr Syrsky, said that Ukraine had advanced between 28 to 35 kilometers into Kursk Oblast since the start of the operation on August the 6th. According to the general, Ukraine has captured 1,263 square kilometers of Russian territory and 93 settlements. The Economist reported, citing military sources, that Syrsky was considering an attack against Russia's Bryansk Oblast as an alternative to the Kursk incursion. A combined strike against Kursk and Bryansk Oblasts were also under discussion, the outlet wrote, without revealing further details. The main goal of the operation was to strengthen Kyiv's position in potential negotiations and draw away Russian troops from Donbas, the Economist wrote. This is consistent with multiple statements by Ukrainian officials. Zelensky also said that Ukraine aims to create a buffer zone on Russian territory, while the foreign ministry noted that the operation is designed to halt Russian cross-border strikes. According to the Economist's sources, the Western partners were not informed about the plans in advance to avoid them being leaked or disrupted. In spite of this, the partners did not protest against the offensive after it was launched, even praising its accomplishments. The meticulous planning, smart tactics, and secrecy helped Ukraine achieve quick tactical success in the first few days, but Ukrainian soldiers are saying the situation is becoming more tense as Russia is pulling in more experienced troops. The latter part of the statement is supported by multiple media reports and statements by officials who said that Russia is rerouting troops from Ukrainian front lines or other Russian regions.
Прям осколки на наш поселочек упали. Пиздец. Ебучие дроны. Уже четвертый, наверное.
Ну тут это лечится.
Вон взорвался, смотри. Вон еще один. Сейчас бать колотить. Вон там его взорвали. Видно прям было. Заснял. Вон он, видишь, смотри. Вон дым.
Уже чуть-чуть рассосался, конечно, но вот это вот, этот вот клубочек был еще сильнее, короче, это все вот этот вот черный дым. Я, короче, как только бахнула, я лежу на полу на кухне, вот. Я поднимаюсь, короче, через пару секунд смотрю, и уже прям такой прям конкретный, бля.